Welcome to Implementing Hybrid Scenarios with Office 365 and SharePoint Server 2013. This is Module 2.1, Architecture, Authentication, and Functionality Overview. The content provided in these modules is intended for organizations who are currently using SharePoint Server 2013 on-premises, have evaluated the benefits and capabilities of SharePoint Online, and are interested in a hybrid SharePoint solution, and would like to learn more about the considerations necessary when planning a hybrid deployment. This module provides an overview of architecture, authentication, and functionality in a hybrid SharePoint environment. This section in Module 2.1, Architecture, Authentication, and Functionality Overview, provides an introduction and overview. Organizations face a significant business challenge today, such as driving IT efficiency and business value in the face of increased pressure to comply with regulations. The goal of any hybridization, or combining of two related but dissimilar entities, is to gain leverage from the strengths of both parts, while minimizing the component's weaknesses. Hybrid computing is based on a computing model that allows organizations to use a combination of traditional and cloud computing environments to achieve a higher degree of flexibility than forcing a choice between either an on-premises or cloud model. Organizations can start to achieve the benefits associated with the use of cloud computing, coupled with the flexibility to customize the environment and govern data as tightly as an on-premises system while delivering a consistent user experience. Hybrid environments can be helpful when it's not possible for an organization to migrate to the cloud immediately or in full due to business, technical, or other reasons. Cloud services such as SharePoint Online and Office 365 can be an attractive alternative to on-premises SharePoint business solutions, but for a variety of reasons, you might need to deploy specific solutions in the cloud while still maintaining your on-premises SharePoint farm. New functionality in SharePoint Server 2013 and SharePoint Online enables you to integrate services like Search, Business Connectivity Services, and Duet Enterprise Online across the on-premises cloud boundary. In a hybrid SharePoint Server 2013 Office 365 environment, you can configure single sign-on to federate your on-premises Active Directory Domain Services domain with your Office 365 Enterprise tenant, just like you could in SharePoint Server 2010. SharePoint Server 2013 also includes native support for OAuth 2.0 to enable server-to-server trust relationships between SharePoint Server and SharePoint Online. A hybrid SharePoint environment uses this server-to-server trust relationship at the service level to deliver cross-boundary functionality and content on behalf of authenticated users. This section of Module 2.1, Architecture, Authentication, and Functionality Overview, provides guidance for the initial phase of the hybrid deployment process, which describes how to configure the basic infrastructure for a hybrid environment using SharePoint Server 2013 and SharePoint Online. Single sign-on gives users seamless authentication, authorization, and access across SharePoint Server on-premises and SharePoint Online. Single sign-on gives users seamless authentication, authorization, and access across SharePoint Server on-premises and SharePoint Online. Single sign-on enables users to use their domain credentials to access servers on the on-premises farm in Office 365. Without single sign-on, network administrators would have to maintain a separate set of online accounts and credentials, and users would be prompted to provide online credentials every time they accessed a SharePoint resource on Office 365. Single sign-on also provides the OAuth infrastructure that is used to allow SAML claims to be passed between SharePoint Server 2013 and SharePoint Online. Through its support for the WS Federation and WS Trust protocols, Active Directory Federation Services 2.0 provides claims-based single sign-on with the Office 365 offering and its web application and rich client applications. A hybrid environment provides three layers of trust and service integration: the Security Token Service, Server-to-Server Trust and Identity Management. This layer enables trusted communications between SharePoint Server 2013 and SharePoint Online, and enables OAuth authentication for federated users. Integration at this level is dependent on the Open Authorization 2.0 Web Authorization Protocol, which is supported in SharePoint Server 2013. Active Directory Synchronization, Domain Federation. This layer enables single sign-on and Active Directory directory synchronization, which provides federated authentication and account synchronization from on-premises Active Directory to Windows Azure Active Directory. Windows Azure Active Directory provides authentication services for Office 365 user accounts and federated accounts from a connected on-premises ADDS domain, and also acts as a trusted token issuer in hybrid deployments. Server-to-server trust, service integration. This layer enables integration between supported SharePoint Server 2013 and SharePoint Online services, such as Search, Business Connectivity Services, and Duet Enterprise Online. Integration at this level is dependent on new features and integration support included in SharePoint Server 2013. Your choice of an authentication topology determines how you configure certificates and the capabilities of your hybrid solution. In a one-way outbound topology, the SharePoint Server 2013 environment connects to SharePoint Online. From on-premises, on-premises SharePoint Server 2013 users can see both local and remote search results. From SharePoint Online, users of the SharePoint Online search portal can only see local results. In a one-way inbound topology, SharePoint Online connects to an on-premises SharePoint Server 2013 farm through a reverse proxy device. From on-premises, on-premises SharePoint 2013 users can see only local search results. From online, users of the SharePoint Online search portal can see both local and remote search results. In a two-way topology, the on-premises SharePoint Server 2013 farm connects to SharePoint Online. SharePoint Online connects to an on-premises SharePoint 2013 farm through a reverse proxy device. From on-premises, on-premises SharePoint 2013 users can see both local and remote search results. From online, users of the SharePoint Online search portal can see both local and remote search results. For Extranet users, if you configure Extranet authentication services, Extranet users can log in remotely with an on-premises Active Directory account and use all of the available hybrid functionality. With business connectivity services from SharePoint Online, users can perform both read and write operations. The Business Connectivity Services service connects to an on-premises SharePoint Server 2013 farm. The Business Connectivity Services service is configured on the on-premises farm and brokers the connection to an on-premises OData service endpoint. It requires an app for SharePoint or an external list installed on the SharePoint Online site collection. Prior to deploying services to users, the identity infrastructure must be configured. There are 7 basic steps to be performed to configure the hybrid identity infrastructure. Configuration of the on-premises security token service. Establishing a federation trust. Installing updates for cloud services subscriptions. Creation of or acquiring certificates. Configuring SharePoint Server 2013. Configuring SharePoint Online. And lastly, configuring a reverse proxy device. Depending on business needs, technical requirements, or both, directory synchronization is the most common provisioning choice for enterprise customers who are moving to Office 365. Directory synchronization allows identities to be mastered on-premises, and all updates to that identity are synchronized to Office 365. There are a couple of things to keep in mind when you plan an implementation of directory synchronization, including directory preparation and the requirements and functionality of Windows Azure Active Directory. Directory preparation covers quite a few areas. They include attribute updates, auditing, and planning domain controller placement. Planning requirements and functionality includes determining the permissions that are required, planning for multi-forest directory scenarios, capacity planning, and two-way synchronization. In Office 365, the source of authority refers to the location where Active Directory service objects, such as users and groups, are mastered, the original source that defines copies of an object in a cross-premises deployment. You can change the source of authority for an object by using one of these scenarios: activate, deactivate, or reactivate directory synchronization from within Office 365 or with Windows PowerShell. Source of authority is transferred from Office 365 to your on-premises directory service after you perform the first sync. The on-premises Active Directory forest must meet specific requirements. They include requirements for the schema master, global catalog servers, and domain controllers. It's important to carefully read the latest requirements and ensure that your on-premises directory servers meet those requirements. To help ensure a seamless transition to Office 365 by using synchronization, we highly recommend that you prepare your Active Directory forest before you begin your Office 365 directory synchronization deployment. Your organization may want to use Active Directory auditing to capture and evaluate the events that are associated with directory synchronization, such as user creation, password reset, and adding users to groups. By implementing directory synchronization, auditing captures directory service logs from your Active Directory domain controllers. Note that security logging may be disabled by default. You have to understand how to enable it for your organization. The Directory Sync tool synchronizes with a single sign-on on-premises Active Directory forest. To enable a web application or application service to request a resource from a web application on another farm on behalf of a user, you must configure server-to-server authentication between farms. A few examples of SharePoint 2013 processes that use server-to-server authentication are following a document on a team site web application when a user's personal site is located on a My Sites web application. The team site's web application makes a request of the My Sites web application on behalf of the user. Creating or replying to a site feed post for a site that is located on a team site's web application, but performed through the user's My Site news feed on the My Sites web application. The My Sites web application will make a request of the team site's web application on behalf of the user to write the post or the reply. Or lastly, a user profile service application task to populate the feed cache has to read from the personal site or team site. If the user profile service application is running in a different farm, the user profile service application sends a request to the My Sites web application or team site's web application to read the user or site feed data into the cache. A hybrid SharePoint 2013 environment introduces several components discussed in this and later modules, including Microsoft Online Services Directory Synchronization, Active Directory Federation Services, Microsoft Online Directory Service, Windows Azure Directory Service Access Control Services. This section in Module 2.1 provides an overview of hybrid workload considerations with Office 365 and SharePoint 2013. A hybrid SharePoint search environment allows users to get search results in SharePoint Server 2013 or in SharePoint Online from the SharePoint Server 2013 and SharePoint Online search indexes. A hybrid SharePoint environment is composed of an on-premises deployment of SharePoint Server 2013 and an instance of Office 365. In such an environment, the SharePoint 2013 search index and the SharePoint Online search index typically contain different content. The SharePoint 2013 search index can contain crawled content from local SharePoint server sites, file shares, and other resources. The SharePoint Online search index can contain crawled content only from SharePoint Online sites. Hybrid search enables end users to get and view search results from both indexes by performing a single search. The SharePoint 2013 and Office 2013 suites also include business connectivity services. With business connectivity services, you can use SharePoint 2013 and Office 2013 clients as an interface into data that doesn't live in SharePoint 2013 itself. It does this by making a connection to the data source, running a query, and then returning the results. Business connectivity services returns the results to the user through an external list or an app for SharePoint or Office 2013, where you can perform different operations against them, such as create, read, update, delete, and query. Business connectivity services can access external data sources through open data, Windows Communication Foundation endpoints, web services, cloud-based services, and .NET assemblies, or through custom connectors. SharePoint 2013 introduces support for OData business connectivity services connections. This is in addition to data connections for WCF, SQL Server, and .NET assemblies. The Open Data Protocol is a web protocol that is used to query and update data. OData applies web technologies such as HTTP, Atom Publishing Protocol, and JavaScript Object Notation to provide access to information from a variety of applications, services, and stores. The Business Connectivity Services hybrid deployment scenario allows you to securely publish on-premises data to an external list or app for SharePoint and SharePoint Online. From there, users can view and edit the data, depending on the permissions that they have. The business connectivity services hybrid scenario requires a successful deployment of either a one-way inbound or two-way SharePoint hybrid configuration. This section in Module 2.1, Architecture, Authentication, and Functionality Overview, provides the workload considerations associated with hybrid architecture. There are several considerations an organization must evaluate prior to considering a hybrid social topology. Although SharePoint Server 2013 provides basic enterprise social features, Yammer provides a richer enterprise social experience. Yammer is a best-in-class enterprise social network that brings together employees, content, conversations, and business data in a single location. Yammer empowers employees to be more productive by enabling them to collaborate in real time across departments, geographies, and business applications. You can add Yammer functionality to your SharePoint sites by adding Yammer to the navigation bar or by using the Yammer app to embed a Yammer feed into a site. The new Yammer app for SharePoint lets you embed Yammer feeds into on-premises SharePoint 2013 sites to make them more social and engaging. Before you can do that, you have to both remove the newsfeed web parts from My Sites and Team Sites and hide the user interface controls that provide the social features that you'll replace with Yammer. Next, you'll add the Yammer app to the app catalog and install and set up the Yammer feed on your sites. Yammer comes in two varieties, Yammer Basic and Yammer Enterprise. Yammer Basic is free and available to all users. It provides a way for employees to collaborate with other members of their organization. Yammer Enterprise is a premium version that extends an organization's basic Yammer network. It's offered both as a standalone product and with various SharePoint Online and Office 365 plans. Yammer Enterprise provides additional tools and resources to help organizations set up the best possible enterprise social network. There are three primary options for the integration of Yammer in SharePoint 2013. Add Yammer to the navigation bar for SharePoint 2013. You can use a toggle switch to replace the newsfeed link with a Yammer link on the top navigation bar for SharePoint. This functionality is included in Service Pack 1 for SharePoint Server 2013. Use Yammer instead of SharePoint newsfeed features. To take advantage of features provided by Yammer, it's a good idea to replace the default SharePoint 2013 enterprise social features with equivalent Yammer features. You can remove the SharePoint Server social web parts from My Sites and Team Sites, and then you can hide the user interface controls that provide social functionality. And lastly, use the Yammer app for SharePoint. The new Yammer app for SharePoint lets you embed Yammer feeds, such as the home feed and group feed or comment feeds, into on-premises sites to make them more social and engaging. Business intelligence is essentially a set of tools and processes that organizations use to collect and analyze data, and then use that data to make better business decisions. Office 365 Pro Plus offers business intelligence capabilities that enable you to use your data to create reports and then share information with people in your organization. Excel 2013 offers a lot of business intelligence capabilities to help you explore and analyze data. SharePoint Online enables you to share, view, and explore workbooks in a browser window. Power BI for Office 365 supports more advanced self-service capabilities. SharePoint Online Plan 2 enables users to view and interact with a workbook in a browser window, similar to how it works in Excel. You can typically use filters, slicers, and timeline controls to focus on more specific information in charts and tables. In a Power Pivot report or in a Pivot Table report, you can use Quick Explore to view additional information about a particular value, and then you can open the field list to temporarily change what information is displayed. Workbooks that contain Power View sheets are supported. A few things that are currently not supported in SharePoint Online include views that were created by using PowerMap, Flash Fill, and Quick Analysis. To use those features, users must open the workbook in Excel. Depending on the data sources that are used, users might be unable to refresh data in a workbook in a browser window. The public website in SharePoint Online, which is part of Office 365, can be used to quickly and easily create a professional online presence for your business or organization. The website is ideal for small and mid-sized businesses because it contains simple design tools to create and maintain a website on the internet. If on the other hand, you have a much larger or complex website need, such as web content management, multilingual sites, or online commerce, you should consider an internet publishing site in SharePoint Server 2013. The public website in SharePoint Online is a hosted site that can be customized using just a browser. Once you sign into Office 365, you can immediately add and edit pages, change the site theme, and optimize the site for search engine optimization, add social media apps, and much more. You can even use advanced site design features like Design Manager to create a custom design from scratch. When finished, you can make the website public and then add a custom domain name. It's a great way to quickly and easily create a website without having to know how to edit HTML, upload pages, or build website features. In addition to the online public website, there's another SharePoint-based website option tailored to larger businesses and organizations. It's called an Internet Publishing Site, and you create this using SharePoint Server 2013. This type of site is suited to larger organizations that need robust enterprise-scale sites with web content management, commerce capabilities, multilingual variations, line of business integration, and more. An Internet Publishing Site is currently not available in SharePoint Online. You need to build this type of site in SharePoint Server 2013 in an on-premises deployment. If you want to host the site in the cloud, you might consider the SharePoint deployment in Windows Azure. You should include planning for external sharing as part of your overall permissions planning for SharePoint Online. In general, it's a best practice to operate on the principle of least privilege and grant external users minimal and limited access to your environment. You may want to even create a special permissions group to which external users are assigned when they receive invitations. You should also consider segmenting your content by security levels so that sensitive content is centrally located and can be tightly secured. If you anticipate an ongoing need to have external users log into your site and perform specific tasks, consider creating a site collection that is dedicated to the purpose of external sharing. This way, you can allow external users access to specific content without opening up your entire environment to them. To determine whether to use a public or private cloud, an organization must comply with the security policy in place along with all relevant regulations for the assets that it manages. Consequently, a data classification effort constitutes a mandatory starting point. A security risk management process can, for instance, leverage the following three qualitative asset classes: high business impact. Would the impact on confidentiality, integrity, or availability of these assets cause a severe or catastrophic loss to an organization? Impact may be expressed in raw financial terms or may reflect indirect loss or theft of financial instruments, organizational productivity, damage to reputation, or significant legal and/or regulatory liability. Moderate business impact. Impact on the confidentiality, integrity, or availability of these assets causes moderate loss to the organization. Moderate loss does not constitute a severe or catastrophic impact, but does disrupt normal business organizational functions to the degree that proactive controls are necessary to minimize impact within this asset class. And lastly, low business impact. Assets that don't fall into either high business impact or medium business impact are classified as low business impact and have no formal protection requirements or additional controls beyond standard best practices for securing infrastructure. This is typically publicly accessible information that must only be protected against modification by unauthorized individuals. A records management solution distributed across SharePoint 2013 and SharePoint Online requires careful planning, both in how records are managed and where content is stored based on its business impact. Before you plan your records management solution, you should work with your administrators to plan the solution. A record center site serves as an archive, and documents are copied into the archive only when they become records. Whether a document was a record or not was determined by whether it lived in the records archive or elsewhere. Managing records in place is an alternative to the traditional process of copying and moving records to another location and then applying security and retention policies. You can manage records in place, which means that you can leave a document in its current location on a site, declare it as a record, and apply the appropriate security, retention, and disposition properties to that record. A hybrid approach is also possible. For example, you can keep records in place with active documents for 2 years and then move the records to a records archive when a project is completed. These considerations are discussed in depth in later modules. Module 2.1, Architecture, Authentication, and Functionality Overview, provided an overview of the basic architecture, authentication, and functional considerations of a hybrid SharePoint deployment, including the basic requirements for configuring workloads, single sign-on, server-to-server trust, and additional considerations. Module 2.2 Next provides an overview of directory synchronization with single sign-on for a hybrid SharePoint environment.